क्या आप आईएएस की तैयारी कर रहे हैं और कोचिंग इंस्टीट्यूट्स को 2.5 लाख तक की फीस नहीं पे करना चाहते? अगर हाँ तो 22,500 रुपए में घर बैठ के StudyIQ के पेन ड्राइव कोर्स के साथ आप आईएएस की तैयारी कर सकते हैं। आज ही विजिट करें studyiq.com।
हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम टू StudyIQ। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द कमिटी ऑन फेयर मार्केट कंडक्ट एंड दिस कमिटी ऑन द फेयर मार्केट कंडक्ट वॉज हेडेड बाई फॉर्मर लॉ सेक्रेटरी TK विश्वनाथ। सो this committee is popularly known as TK Vishwanathan Committee on Fair Market Conduct. This committee was set up by SEBI, that is Securities and Exchange Board of India. And the purpose of forming this committee was to suggest measures for improving the surveillance of the markets and strengthen the rules for trading. So trading in the markets should be improved, and in order to suggest measures for this improvement was the objective of this committee. And this is a very important committee. The recommendations of this committee are important, and also there are various criticisms regarding this committee that this committee has suggested for granting more powers to SEBI, and this granting of powers has led to many concerns. So the report of this committee was submitted very recently, and therefore it is an important current affair for the upcoming examinations. So let us start. First of all, let us see what is SEBI. SEBI is Securities and Exchange Board of India. SEBI was established by the Government of India in the year 1988. But this year is not very important. The important year is 1992. So SEBI was given a statutory status on April 12th, 1992, and this date is important. And this statutory status was given through the SEBI Act of 1992, the Securities and Exchange Board of India Act 1992 gave SEBI a statutory status. And coming to the basic functions of SEBI, the first function is to regulate the securities market. Secondly, to secure the market from malpractices. Thirdly, educate the investors, that is to protect the interest of the investors and secure investors' interest. So these are the basic functions of the SEBI. We can say that SEBI is the watchdog of securities market in India. And what is securities market? We will see later in this lecture itself. And where is SEBI headquartered? SEBI is headquartered in Mumbai, and it has 4 other regional offices in Kolkata, Delhi, Chennai and Ahmedabad. Now let us see what is security markets. So security market is an exchange or a market where the sale and purchase of securities are conducted. So here the sale and purchase of securities are done. And how is this done? On the basis of demand and supply. So based on the demand and supply for securities, the purchase and sale of these securities are conducted under the securities market. And coming to the securities market, there are basically 2 types of securities markets. First one is primary markets. So primary market is where a new security is issued by a company. So if a company issues new security and which is purchased directly by the investor, it is known as a primary market. So we can say that under the primary market, a company sells its securities to the public directly. So there is a direct selling of securities by the company to the general public. So primary market is a market for the new issues of securities by the companies. And also we have a secondary market. So in the secondary market, existing securities can be bought and sold. So existing securities are transacted in the secondary market, which means that the investors buy shares from another investor instead of the issuer. That means trading of already issued securities among investors occurs in the secondary market. In order to make it more clear, I will give you an example. First of all, the issuer. Let us assume the issuer as Infosys Limited. So Infosys is the company and it is the issuer of the securities. And suppose a person A, he has purchased shares or securities from the issuer, that is the company Infosys, directly. This purchase will be from the primary market. That means primary market is the market where the investor, here our investor is A, where A has brought the securities directly from the company or the issuer, that is Infosys. So this will be primary market. Now another investor B. A wants to sell the securities which he has purchased from Infosys, and that too from the primary market. So now A wants to sell it. So where this A will go in order to sell the security? He will go to the secondary market. So in the secondary market, he will find some investor like B. So B is an investor in the secondary market, where B purchases the securities from A in the secondary market. So from this example, it is very clear what is primary market and what is secondary market. I'll briefly explain. Primary market means the market from where the investors buy securities directly from the issuer. And secondary market is a market where the sale and purchase of already existing securities take place. Now here there is another important term, that is IPO. IPO refers to initial public offering. And what is meant by IPO? When a firm issues its shares for the first time, it is called IPO. Let us take our previous example. Here we have seen Infosys has issued shares. Let us assume that Infosys has issued its shares for the first time in 2005. So in 2005, Infosys will issue a set of shares. So this is for the first time, and therefore it is known as IPO, initial public offering. And suppose again in the year 2007, Infosys has issued another set of shares. Can we call it as IPO? No, it cannot be called as an IPO. Why? Because the shares or securities of this company Infosys is already existing in the market. In the year 2005, Infosys has already issued certain shares, and those shares are already existing in the market. So that can be sold in the secondary market by the investors. So when it issues the second set of shares, we cannot call it as IPO. IPO means when a firm issues its shares for the first time in the market, that is initial public offering. I hope now you have a basic idea about what is SEBI and also what is securities market and the two classification of the securities market. With this understanding, you will be able to better understand the TK Vishwanathan Committee, which is based on fair market conduct. And this is basically about securities market. Now, coming back to our topic, that is the Committee on Fair Market Conduct. Let us see what is the constitution of this committee. As we have already said, this committee is chaired by TK Vishwanathan, who is the former law secretary. And the other members are representatives from law firms, mutual funds, retail institutions, institutional brokers, auditing firms, foreign portfolio investors, stock exchanges, chambers of commerce, data analytics, market regulators, etc. So from this composition, we understand that this committee is a broad committee and also includes various stakeholders, or we can say that all the stakeholders are involved in this committee, and there is a fair representation from all the parties who are involved in the securities market. Now let us see why there is a need in order to constitute such a committee. First of all, we have seen what is securities market, what is the nature of securities market. So we have seen that in the primary market as well as in the secondary market, securities of companies are traded. So these securities are of very dynamic nature. It undergoes constant change. And because of this dynamic nature of the securities market, a periodic review is very, very important. So when a thing is constantly changing, it must be reviewed periodically. And this periodic review will help in better regulations and also better surveillance. So that was first objective of this committee. In order to conduct a periodic review of the regulations and surveillance because of the dynamic nature of the securities market. And coming to the second objective, we will find that there were various illegal practices undergoing in the securities market, and it was very necessary that fair conduct must be ensured in the securities market because of this illegal practices. So the second objective was to address the illegal practices and to ensure fair conduct among the investors in the securities market. Now let us see what are the key recommendations of this TK Vishwanathan Committee. Coming to the key recommendations, the first category is regarding the malpractices in the securities market. The first one is binami trading. The committee recommended that binami trading should also be deemed or considered as fraudulent practice if it leads to manipulation. What is meant by binami trading? Binami trading means you are conducting the trading on the name or identity of another person. Secondly, this committee recommended that SEBI should consider any trading by players beyond their financial resources as fraud, which means that if a person is conducting trading more than his financial capacity, that should also be considered as fraud because that is a type of binami transaction. If suppose a person doesn't have so much of financial resources but he conducts various financial trading in the securities market, so what is the source of his financial resources for conducting the trading? So that is a question, and therefore it should be considered as a fraudulent activity. Thirdly, under the malpractices, the committee recommended that existing regulations in the SEBI must be changed in order to better prosecute the malpractices. So there are various regulations that are existing in the SEBI, and this existing regulations must be changed or updated in order to ensure there is better prosecution of the malpractices in the securities market. And fourthly, the committee said that the scope of regulations on fraudulent activities must be expanded. So right now the fraudulent activities are aimed at only the intermediaries. So intermediaries are involved in the definition of fraudulent activities. So this committee suggested that along with the intermediaries, the employees, the agents, etc. should be included under the definition of fraudulent activity conducted by the stakeholders. So the expansion for the scope of regulations must be done. Another suggestion was that the SEBI, Securities and Exchange Board of India, should be granted powers in order to grant immunity to the whistleblowers. Who are whistleblowers? Whistleblowers refers to those who help in order to uncover illegal activities. So protection must be given to the whistleblowers who reveal the illegal activities, and who must be given the power to grant immunity? SEBI must be given the power. So these are the key recommendations under the malpractices. Now coming to insider trading, let us see what are the recommendations given by the committee with regard to insider trading. So first of all, what is insider trading? It is a practice wherein the investment decisions are made by having access to otherwise non-public information. Suppose there are non-public information, which means those information that are not revealed to the general public. And if some person or some investors are getting information regarding the non-public information, that is such information which are not public, but certain investors are getting clue about this non-public information, that is known as insider trading. So it is basically access to non-public information. With regard to the insider trading, the committee recommended to create two separate codes of conduct for insider trading. So the first code of conduct will be for insider trading that is conducted by listed companies, and secondly by the market intermediaries. So the committee recommended that there should be separate code of conduct for the insider trading done in the securities market. The third recommendation was with regard to the information. The committee recommended that the companies should maintain the details of immediate relatives of the persons who might deal with sensitive information, and also people with whom the designated person might share a material or an information. So, companies should be able to maintain the details, and such information maintained by the company should be in a searchable electronic format. And also, this information should be shared with the SEBI, Securities and Exchange Board of India, when SEBI asks for it on a case-to-case basis. So, if there is any requirement, the SEBI would ask for such information and the company should be able to provide such information. So, this was the third major recommendation given by the TK Vishwanathan Committee. The next recommendation is with regard to the calls, the phone calls. So, according to the recommendation of this committee, the SEBI should be given the power to tap telephones and other electronic devices. Right now, what is the power of SEBI? Now, basically, SEBI has the power to only ask for call records, and this includes the numbers and also duration. So, this is the power of SEBI at present. And what is the recommendation of the committee? The committee recommended that in order to check insider trading, we have seen what is insider trading. It is access to non-public information. And in order to check the insider trading and other fraudulent activities, the SEBI must be given direct power to tap telephone calls and also other electronic communication devices. Now let us see what are the benefits of such recommendation. First of all, a strong regulator, that is SEBI. SEBI is the regulator of the securities market, and we have seen through this recommendations, the securities market regulator, that is the SEBI, will be empowered and it will become a strong regulator. It gives certain powers to SEBI. So, a strong regulator can be a good deterrent to fraudulent practices in the market. So, this will help SEBI to empower itself and face the fraudulent practices in the market in a better manner. And secondly, these recommendations provide greater executive powers to SEBI. And this executive powers can help the SEBI to take swifter action against the offenders. Otherwise, what happens? They will have to depend on government bodies like ministry, law and order, legal procedures, etc. Now, if the recommendations are put in place, this will empower SEBI to itself take action against the offenders. And this recommendations also will help SEBI provide more autonomy, and this will free SEBI from political influences. And we have seen that SEBI is the watchdog of the securities market, and SEBI can understand the complexities of the securities market than anybody else. So, better enforcement of the laws can be done through SEBI. So, these are the advantages associated with this recommendations. But on the other hand, there are also various concerns with regard to the recommendations, because these recommendations are providing for enormous powers to the Securities and Exchange Board of India. Now, let us look at what are the contentions associated with this recommendations. First of all, regarding the calls, we have seen that this committee recommended that SEBI should be granted powers to tap the telephonic calls. Already this is done by police and also various investigating agencies like the CBI. So, one major criticism of this recommendation is that this would be very extreme, because we have already seen there are various privacy issues that are going on. So, on the top of that, providing powers in order to tap calls for a financial regulator would be an extreme measure. So, this is one important concern that is associated with these recommendations. And the second one is with regard to fraudulent activities or fraud. We have seen that under the recommendations, SEBI is provided powers not only to take action against the intermediaries but also against various other stakeholders. So, what will happen? This will lead to too much of regulations, and there are chances of misuse of such powers by the financial regulator also. So, this misuse as well as excessive regulations will lead to decrease in the investments. So, this can be a reason that can possibly discourage the investors to invest in the securities market. So, these are the concerns that are associated with the recommendations of TK Vishwanathan Committee. And here you must remember that these are only recommendations these are not put into practice. So before these recommendations are put into practice, it is very necessary to go into the details of the concerns and address the concerns very well. You can find the PDF of this lecture on my Facebook page. Thank you.
क्या आप आईएएस की तैयारी कर रहे हैं और कोचिंग इंस्टीट्यूट्स को 2.5 लाख तक की फीस नहीं पे करना चाहते? अगर हाँ, तो 22,500 रुपए में घर बैठ के StudyIQ के पेनड्राइव कोर्स के साथ आप आईएएस की तैयारी कर सकते हैं। आज ही विजिट करें studyiq.com।